हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन एडू क्लासेस ऑफ ब्रिलियंट पब्लिक स्कूल बाय कैलाश कुमार सर। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विथ आवर प्रीवियस टॉपिक ऑफ क्लास 6 इंग्लिश यूनिट 6 सेक्शन 1 लॉब्स गर्ल बाय जोएन आइकन एंड दिस इज द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ आवर वीडियो। चिल्ड्रन, इन द फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ आवर वीडियो वी स्टडीड ऑल अबाउट द मीटिंग ऑफ सैंडी एंड लॉब एंड देयर बॉन्ड ऑफ लव दैट लेड लॉब्स ओनर टू गिफ्ट लॉब टू पेंगली फैमिली फॉर एवर। एवरीथिंग वॉज गोइंग वेल फॉर 9 years अंटिल अनफॉर्चुनेटली सैंडी एंड लॉब मेट विथ एन अनएक्सपेक्टेड ट्रेजिक एक्सीडेंट वाइल क्लाइंबिंग अप द स्टीप हिल टू स्टे विथ हर आंट बेकी, एज आंट बेकी वॉज अलोन बिकॉज Sandy's uncle, Will Hoskins, had gone for fishing. Now the story moves ahead and let's find out what happened next after the accident, which was witnessed by Dr. Travers and his wife Emily while driving through Cornwall. She's been hit. Can't be more than a few minutes. Remember that truck that overtook us half a mile back, speeding like the devil? Quick phone for an ambulance. The girl is in a bad way. I'll stay here and stop the bleeding, he said sharply. Bleeding means loose blood from the body due to injury. Now Dr. Travers and his wife, while moving through Cornwall through that narrow steep hill, they saw that truck which was overspeeding and overtook them. And unfortunately, that truck met with an accident and collapsed with that post office wall. And due to that accident, Sandy and Lob, they both were hit. So Sandy was in a miserable condition, lying there half submerged in water. And this was witnessed, or this was seen by Emily. And she asked her husband to quick phone for an ambulance as the girl is in a bad way. So her husband said that go and call for an ambulance while the time I am stopping the bleeding. Dr. Travers was able to stop bleeding. The girl was lying in a queerly crumpled heap and he guessed she had a number of bones broken. So Dr. Travers was able to stop the bleeding and the girl was lying in very miserable state, very miserable, helpless condition. Queerly means in a strange way. Crumpled means crushed or bent. Heap means untidily placed on top of each other. And this was the condition while Sandy was lying there. She was lying in a very strange way and crushed and untidily way as she was badly hit by the truck. And Dr. Travers also guessed that maybe the girl had got number of bones broken and many fractures. Mrs. Travers was very quick and in a few minutes an ambulance was wheeling down. Wheeling means making a prolonged high-pitched sound, as you all are aware with the sound of ambulance. It is similar to police van. So the ambulance was wheeling down the hill. It lifted the child and the ambulance sped off to Plymouth and Dr. Travers went down to the police station to report. So this is the situation there. Emily reacted quickly and she called for the ambulance. Within a minute, the ambulance reached there by producing that wailing sound and she was taken to the hospital. When Aunt Rebecca reached Sandy's home, she found the family with white shocked faces. Bert and Jean were about to drive off to the hospital where Sandy had been taken and the twins were crying bitterly. Lob was nowhere to be seen. Oh, if only I had never invited the poor child, wailed Mrs. Hoskins. That night seemed to last forever. The twins cried themselves to sleep. So this was the condition there after the accident. Bert and Jean were just about to drive off to reach that hospital where Sandy was admitted after the accident, and the twins were crying too bitterly. And the most suspense part was that Lob was nowhere to be seen. Lob was not found at the spot of the accident. And Mrs. Hoskins was
cursing herself that because of her only this problem arised in the family. And that night seemed to last forever, and everyone expected that this night should never come in their life. And the twins finally, they slept by crying bitterly. Dawn came home very late. Bert and Jean sat in a waiting room of the Western Counties Hospital, but Sandy was unconscious and there was no Lob. At noon next day, Dr. Travers and Mrs. Travers went to the Pengilly cottage to inquire how Sandy was doing. But the report was gloomy. The report was totally dull and sad. Still in a very serious condition. So the next day, next afternoon, Dr. and Mrs. Travers went to inquire about the condition of Sandy. But the report came was very unexpected. The condition was that Sandy was still in a very serious condition. She did not come to her senses till now. The Western Counties Hospital is a large one, very large hospital it was, as you can see in this image. But by that afternoon, it became noticeable that a dog seemed to have taken a position outside the hospital with the fixed intention of getting in. So the people, those who were in hospital or the security person, they all noticed that a dog was outside the hospital and it was trying to get inside the hospital. Sometimes he would get a little way inside but firmly turned out again. So the dog was doing a number of attempts to enter inside the hospital, but he was again returning back by fear of the other people. Sometimes the guard at the main entrance offered him a bit of sandwich, but he never ate the sandwich. And the guard also offered sandwich to Lob so that he can eat, but Lob did not eat that sandwich. At tea time, Granny Pierce came through the pouring rain to bring a flask of hot tea to her daughter and son-in-law. "Why, bless me, old Mrs. Pierce, that's Lob. Here, Lob, Lobby boy." Lob ran to her, winning. Winning means the making of a long, high-pitched cry or sound. So this sound the dog produces, you all are well aware of such kind of sound. So when when Mrs. Pierce called for the Lob, that he should come towards that way to Mrs. Pierce, Lob ran to her winning. "I am sorry, madam, can't bring that dog in here," the guard said. The guard said to Mrs. Pierce that you can't call that dog here inside the hospital. It is against the rule of the hospital. Mrs. Pierce was a determined old lady, and for this question of the security guard, Mrs. Pierce replied to her in a very determined way, very bold way. "Now, see here, young man, that dog has walked 20 miles from St. Killian to get to my granddaughter." Mrs. Pierce is explaining that what is the importance of the dog to meet Sandy, who was lying unconscious in that hospital. So she told that this dog Lob has walked 20 miles from St. Killian to see Sandy, to meet Sandy, and he ought to have his rights, and that dog has his rights to meet Sandy. He ought to get to see her. Do you know? She went on bristling. Bristling means react angrily or defensively. Yes, actually she was taking Lob's part and she was defending that security guard against that rule. So Mrs. Pierce went on bristling that has walked the length of England twice to be with that girl. So she also described further that how much distance the dog has covered. Means in the length, if we consider, then the dog has covered twice the length of the England. Let's continue. And you think you can keep him out with your fiddling rules and regulations. Fiddling means useless. So here Mrs. Pierce is replying to the guard that you can't keep him away, you can't stop him to meet Sandy by your such type of useless rules and regulations. Finally, the medical officer relented. Relented means became less severe or less strict, and he allowed, the medical officer allowed, so that the lob can meet Sandy. It's strictly against every rule, but as it's such a serious case, we are making an exception, he said to her quietly. But only for a moment or two, the medical officer allowed Mrs. Pierce that the lob can go and meet, go and see Sandy, but only for 1 minute or 2 minutes, not more than that. Without a word, Lob followed Granny Pierce. They walked to Sandy's room. Bert and Jean were inside. Everything was terribly quiet. So this was the condition there inside that room of medical, of that hospital where Sandy was admitted. Lob followed quietly to Mrs. Granny Pierce and reached to that room. There was a narrow bed with a lot of gadgets around it. Sandy lay there very still, so without any movement in hands or legs or any other such movement, she was lying still. All Lob's attention was riveted. Riveted means direct one's eyes or attention. So his eyes were on Sandy, who was lying on bed. Lob let out a faint whine, anxious and pleading. So Lob started producing a sound, which you all are well aware of the dog, how they produce. At the sound of that whine, Sandy stirred just a little. So after hearing that sound of Lob, there was a little movement in Sandy. She sighed. Sighed means to emit a long, deep breath expressing relief. So there was some movement in Sandy, and she came to her senses when she heard the sound of Lob. Her eyes opened, looking at the door. Lob, she murmured. Lobby boy. So this was the word by which Sandy called to Lob when she saw Lob coming towards her. Sandy moved her left arm, the one that was not broken, and let her hand dangle down as she always did in the mornings for Lob's furry head. Dangle means hang or swing loosely. So when Lob approached near the bed, she moved her left arm, left hand, and she started praising the dog by moving her hand freely over the Lob's head. And she used to do this daily in the morning. Granny Pierce and Lob moved to the bedside. She looked at the smile on her granddaughter's face as the groping fingers found Lob's wet ears and gently pulled them. Good boy, whispered Sandy and fell asleep again. So she was even groping. Groping means move along uncertainly by feeling objects. As she was not able to easily move her left arm also, as she was totally injured and got many fractures. So after moving her fingers over Lob's head, she found that Lob's ears were totally wet. So she gently pulled the ears of Lob, and in Lob's ears she whispered, good boy, and she fell asleep again. Granny Pierce led Lob out into the passage again. There he ran off swiftly down the stairs. So finally, Lob was out of the hospital after meeting Sandy, and when he came out of the hospital, he ran off swiftly. Swiftly means very speedily, very fast down the stairs. Bert and Jean had come out into the passage. "Listen, Mother," said Bert. "Lob was killed by the same truck that hit Sandy. Don found him. He was dead. Don rode a half mile out to the sea and sank the dog with a lump of concrete tied to his collar. Poor old boy."
"Sank him at sea? Then what?"
So, this is a very mysterious thing, children. Bert and Jean, they informed to Mother that Lob was also hit by the truck, and due to that accident, Lob was killed there. But how come he is able to come to the hospital? And their elder brother, Don, he rode a half mile out to the sea and sank the Lob, the dog, with a lump of concrete tied to his collar, and so that he can sink inside the water of the river. So this way, Don and Bert and Jean, they were well aware about the death of Lob. But how come he was able to come there to hospital to meet Sandy? So this was very shocking moment for everyone. Now let us see what happens next. Slowly, old Mrs. Pierce and then the other two turned to look at the trail of dripping wet footprints that led down the hospital stairs. Now the next thing was to inquire to get the answer that how Lob was there at the hospital when he was actually dead and he was already sank by Don in the water by tying a lump of concrete to his collar. Trail means a mark or a series of signs or objects left behind by the passage of someone or something. So you can say the prints or the footprints. So they all followed the footprints or the trail of the dripping wet footprints. Dripping means wet. So by following the footprints, the wet footprints which followed to the hospital stairs, and it was going outside the
in the Pengelly's garden. They have a stone under the palm tree. It says Lob, Sandy's dog, buried at sea. So as a matter of love and gratitude, the Pengelly family, in their garden under the palm tree, they kept a stone on which it was inscribed or it was written, Lob, Sandy's dog, buried at sea. So this was done to express their tribute towards Lob, as the life which Sandy got after the accident was due to just because of Lob's love towards Sandy, which led him come to the hospital and raised the hope to live the life, or else Sandy would have died. These all things happened even after the death of Lob. He returned to meet Sandy. So finally we have reached to the end, children. I hope you all found this story very interesting and unique, and also you liked this story very much. Please do watch the previous parts also in case you don't understand anything. Thank you all. Have a safe and happy learning. God bless you all. Take care.